All right, there's more bad news about our education system, sadly. A new report has found too many students are now reaching Year 9 with only a primary school level reading ability. The Productivity Commission says it comes down to our teachers being overworked and poorly trained. Joining me now to discuss this is Senior Research Fellow at the ACU, Dr. Kevin Donnelly. Kevin, good to see you again. Does this problem begin, do you think, at the tertiary level, where and when universities and colleges have to choose who is qualified to study teaching?
Chris, that's one reason, but I remember I started teaching many, many years ago when Gough Whitlam was the Prime Minister, and we had the Carmel Report back then, and that spent millions and millions of dollars trying to overcome disadvantage in schools for working class, migrant, Aboriginal children. And ever since, we seem to have a report or an inquiry two or three times a year. So we've had Gonski, we've had computers in schools, we've had the establishment of ACARA, the National Body for Curriculum, AITSL. I mean, the reality is nothing will improve unless you look at all the factors that are going to that impact on educational outcomes. Now, you're right, teacher quality is very, very important, and we can't unscramble the egg, as they say, but when I was at university, we did a three-year undergraduate degree. I looked at literature and politics. Then I did a diploma of education for a year. So when I started teaching, I had a very substantial grounding in the subject that I was teaching. Mm. But unfortunately, that went many years ago. And so we're getting teachers going into schools who aren't properly grounded in their subject area.
And what about when they, and what about when they get into the classroom, Kevin? Is that another problem? Are they being monitored enough? Are they getting the right training in the first 5 years of their teaching profession?
It's one of the issues, but when I say there's no magic solution, you have to look at curriculum. And as you know, I reviewed the national curriculum in 2014. I'd argue that hasn't gone far enough, the changes they made recently. And Liberal and Labor governments have dropped the ball on this. The national curriculum is a mile wide, an inch deep, very superficial. You've got an assessment and a reporting system that is drowning teachers in detail. Primary teachers take weeks and weeks to write these descriptive reports. I mean, when I was at school, you gave a test, 10 out of 10, 100 out of 100. You actually failed kids on occasion. But we've now moved towards a curriculum and assessment system, which is very, very de-skilling, very cumbersome. Plus, we're drowning schools. And this is a problem that our school leaders, principals always talk about. We've got two levels of government all imposing this kind of bureaucratic overload from the top, and it's destroying the autonomy, flexibility that schools need.
I hope the Education Minister, Jason Clare, is listening to this, because what you're saying is so true. One quick one. Of course, they've had to deal with the pandemic. This generation drew the short straw, didn't they?
They did, and there's no denying that. But, you know, just to be counterintuitive, I've spoken to some parents, whether it's Queensland, New South Wales or in Victoria, who have actually moved to homeschooling, who are, because of COVID, seeing what their kids were doing at home in the virtual classroom, have become very worried, concerned about how woke the curriculum is. So for some families, it's been a good wake-up call, because parents are their children's primary educators, their children's moral guardians, and they're responsible. They should do more to make it easier for teachers.
They must, including reading to them as much as we possibly can. Kevin Donnelly, Senior Research Fellow at ACU, thank you so much for your time. Enjoy your weekend of footy.